Hello everyone, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we are going to check out the Rockwood Mini Lite 1905. Rockwood being the number one fiberglass travel trailer out there, there's several reasons behind that. One of them is for sure their construction. They have the best construction that I can find out of every manufacturer out there. They have vacuum bonded walls where they don't have to worry about it delaminating nearly as much as a pinch rolled wall. The statistic is about 1 in 22 walls fail, whereas Rockwood it's 1 in over 900. The other thing that you'll like about these guys is it has a solid roof. You don't have to worry about walking in between each truss before it bows in. Also, it's actually a TPO membrane, which is a higher grade than your typical EPDM rubber roof. What that means is you're going to have less chalking, it's more resistant to abrasion, you don't have to maintenance it and put a conditioner on it every year. So if you can buy a TPO roof, you're much better off. You do have an access ladder to the top of the roof if you want. You also have the Furion plate, so if you decide to add a backup camera, you can easily do that with very little labor cost. Over here, you'll notice that these tanks are 12 volt heat pads. That's super nice, so if you do go into some colder weather, you're able to protect your tanks down to negative 11 degrees. Over here, you'll notice the 30 amp connection does have the LED light on it, so if you don't have a good connection or if there's no power at the pedestal, you can easily troubleshoot that. Another thing that Rockwood does is they have TorFlex suspension system. What that means is it gives you independent suspension as you're pulling it down the road. That's going to be a smoother ride for the coach and everything inside of it, and all your welds as well for the way the coach is built. The TorFlex suspension system has a 10-year warranty on it. On top of that, this is an aluminum rim instead of the white painted steel rim, so it's not going to rust and it's going to look a little bit nicer, as well as this is filled with nitrogen. So it's gonna brake better, handle better. The tread life is gonna last longer. Right here, you do have a black tank sewer flush built into this tank. So that means you have sprayers built into the sewer tank that flushes it all out for you. If you don't have that, you end up having to put a wand down the toilet through the inside, and of course dragging a hose inside the coach, putting a wand on there and hopefully not spraying yourself. This is a way more convenient, less messy way to do that. This is an outside shower here. This is a 751 key, so anybody who has a camper probably has this key, just so you know. Hot and cold water ran to this area. Easy place to be able to clean off the fish, rinse off the feet, so you don't track that inside. Over here, this is one of your storage areas. So if you wanted to put your chalk blocks, this is your power cord, by the way. These are all your different hooks, or your, this is for your stabilizer jacks. This one's for your manual override for your power front tongue jack. And then right here, this is just a little utility tray for your kitchen. One of the huge benefits with going with a 1905 is weight, for sure. This weighs 3,100 pounds dry with about a 3,900 pound GVWR. So that's the amount of weight that you need to be able to tow with everything and just what it weighs alone with nothing. You do have two 20 pound propane tanks on here, as well as a battery disconnect. So there's a little red key back here that you can pull, and that disconnects the battery so you don't accidentally drain it while it's in storage. Power tongue jack with the manual override, and there's a light that flashes on here on the front so that you can see what you're doing, and makes the job a lot easier, as well as the secondary light over here on the side. You'll notice this has the nice diamond plate on the front, so that's where all your mud and rocks and everything else is going to hit. And then over here you have a solar port. This is super neat because you can connect, now this is specifically for ZAMP, but you can connect any solar panel as long as you have the connection here. But you plug it in, you put your solar panel out in the sun, of course get it out of the shade of the trees or whatever else you're underneath, and you're ready to go. Over here is just the other side of that storage area. And then you'll notice this is a power awning. This is a Dometic power awning, so that means it's going to run about twice as fast as a Carefree or an LCI awning. So you can get that awning back in and out a lot quicker. Frameless automotive windows, so there's no rubber piece right here to worry about drying out, cracking, and leaking over time. And these windows open up like this, so that this is the hinge part right here. So you can have this open even if it's raining, and you don't have to worry about things getting wet. Large grab assist handle, a spot to put your TV that comes with it, as well as a 110 outlet and a TV connection right here. And then it does come with a grill and a little table that sits right here. And then this is not really a storage area. This is more just an access point. Let me show you what that, you might not even be able to see very much in here. Oh yeah, you can. So this is your 10,000 gallon water filtration system that filters all the water in the entire unit. And then right behind this panel that you just unscrew is your water heater. So this water heater is a little bit fancier. It's a gas electric DSI, so it can give you up to 16.2 gallons of water per hour, and you can run it off just gas, just electric, or both to give you that super fast recovery rate. All right guys, come on inside. I want to show you what it looks like inside this coach. This is probably the coolest the entire coach. I'll let you see what the rest of the coach looks like real quick, and then I'll shut this door behind you. But this is a Murphy bed. So usually in a coach this size, you don't get a full bed. You usually get either not as much room in the coach or not a couch. This gives you everything. So this is cool. So the way this works is, this is storage underneath here, and then this has a couple little locks on both sides. And then this is how easy or hard it is to set up the Murphy bed. This is a heated mattress, so you can set the temperature from 0 to 6 if you want to. You do have to be plugged into 110 for that to work. But yeah, as you can see, you of course only need the bed at nighttime. The rest of the daytime, it's really just taking up unusable space. So to be able to have a couch and a real bed that you're sleeping on, and to be able to do all that within seconds, is super nice. You do have some hanging storage on both sides over here, as you can see. It does have the nicer pleated shades instead of the mini blinds that tend to make a lot more noise. They get dented up. And then this is an emergency exit, so that's the way that works. And then the other type of window on the other side is this kind, and you just twist this guy right here, so and then that opens that way, so that way you can get some breeze going through here, get some cross breeze. And another way to cool down this unit, it does have a 13,500 BTU AC built into it, which is more than enough to cool down this entire unit very easily. But it also has a high powered Creator Breeze fantastic fan in here. That's super nice because you can turn that fan on just based on the battery, open a window, and you can create up to a 10 mile per hour breeze through the entire camper. This TV is on a swing arm, which you can point so that you're already going to have a fairly good view of it anyway, but you can get it even better from the couch. And then this just pushes away. This does have Bluetooth built into it, HDMI, a 5 volt charger so you can quickly charge your battery, DVD player, all built into there. You also have a power center here. So this is a 12 volt outlet as well as two more USB outlets. This is your control panel, so this will tell you how full your batteries are, your interior lights, porch lights, scare light, water pump, gas and electric water heater, tank heaters, everything's built on here, and this is also how you control your awning. You'll notice that they have a flush mount top for this range top. That means you get, you know, maximizing counter space, because, you know, this and your table over here is all the counter space that you get. And, you know, But to be able to maximize that, they put this top on, which is super nice. They also put a knife rack in the back here. And then this also seconds as a backsplash once it's pushed up. This little paper here tells you how to run the TV and the radio. The reason why that TV is kind of impressive is not only is it it's a 24-inch Furion TV. What that means is it's specifically designed for cold weather, hot weather, vibration. It's been tested for all that stuff. Whereas if you put a different type of TV in here, it's not going to work. Like if you just did a Sony or a Toshiba, those aren't necessarily made for all the travel and all the movement that you'll have. It does have the bigger 22-inch oven, as opposed to the 17-inch oven that has a rack about here. So this allows you to put a few more things in it. A spot for your scrubby brush right here. This pulls out. You have a high-rise sink faucet, so if you wanted to be able to put a bigger pan in here, you can do that. This is a window that opens up so you can be able to see out there. You'll notice this has the nice deals here on the side, the little gas struts to be able to hold that open while you're putting stuff in there. And then you do have a gas electric refrigerator, so more storage up here. And then this fridge can run off both propane or 110. This is, by the way, the how you control the heat on the bed. So you just plug that into the very top center, and that'll be able to set that temperature from 0 to 6 that we talked about. Okay, over here you do have extra storage. This is another spot to give you some extra counter space. I'll leave that right in here for you. And then here's another spot to store whatever you need to store. And over here, this is where your water heater is. So that's not really gonna be great storage. Now this table does turn into a bed. So the way this works is there's little rungs right here that you place this table on. And then these parts right here go on top, and that makes into a small bed. And again, more storage up here. So, you know, actually for this being a shorter coach, it has a lot of storage. You'll notice this ceiling is also barreled slightly, so it'll wick away the water as well as make it feel more open and big. You also have controls not only on the side here to be able to control the lights, but also individual buttons. So these are a little bit higher end. They're the LED lights. They run a lot cooler, so they're not going to warm up your coach and fight your AC. And they're going to be brighter in here, and they're not going to use nearly as much battery power. Back here, we already pointed out the high-powered Max Air vent fan, but I wanted to show you the storage area as well. So you have a good size linen closet, towel rack right here, a window for the bathroom, which again, a lot of guys are not putting the windows in the bathroom for some reason. You know, and it's a money saver thing, right? And that's where Rockwood, I feel like, shines, is they put in a lot of different things like the 10,000 gallon water filtration system. They do the nicer vacuum bonded walls. They do the high powered fan. There's a lot of things that these guys do that nobody else is doing in the industry. As you can see, I'm about 5'11", so I have plenty of headroom here with the extra natural light from the skylight here. You know, that's another thing that's an easy miss that a lot of guys in this price point will leave out. You also have a medicine cabinet, not just a mirror on a wall. Again, another place where people try to cut costs. Toothbrush holder, soap holder. Again, on small areas, these things are actually kind of important because otherwise you're taking up all your space just for your toothbrushes and your soap. And then down here, you do have more storage. There is heat ducted down in here. And then you do have a GFI protected outlet right here. And then a on-off switch for the light here and here as well. If you guys could do me a favor, and if you have the kindness in your heart to hit that like button right now, that helps us out greatly. Thank you very much. Also, subscribe to our channel if you want to see a lot of our other videos. And yeah, we have all kinds of different floor plans and models. If this one didn't quite meet your needs, check out something with a slide out maybe. You could check out the 2109S Rockwood Mini Lite or the 2104S Rockwood Mini Lite. All right, guys, our phone number is 970-313-4337. Our website that you can see all these inventory that we currently have in stock is thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.